tribulation starts, I believe pre-tribulation.
That's going to be the springboard. That's going to be the springboard that Antichrist used to bring peace to the world. He's going to explain we were taken by aliens or something, and so he's going to this is going to put him into power.
Because cars will be wrecking and all kinds of
cars, planes.
Okay, so my mind is kind of right.
Oh yeah, okay. Yeah. It's gonna be a bunch of. Can you imagine the pilot? They go up there and the pilot's gone.
I've never talked about that before. I've had them thoughts, but I've never verbalized.
Here's what I do wonder about. I really wonder about, because the Bible says that the rapture, you know, our body's gonna come from the earth, and they're gonna be. But those that are dead, the sea's going to give up its dead, and if your arms over here and your legs over here, it's going to come together, and you're going to get together, and we're going to meet in the middle of the air and go, can you imagine walking along and just had an eye transplant, and all of a sudden, and they go. Or somebody had a heart transplant, and they go,
can you imagine somebody being pre-made and your ashes put in 10 different places?
Yeah.
Now, Jesus, when he was, when he had walked through the wall and all, he said, they thought it was a spirit, and he said, a spirit hath not flesh and bone as you see me have.
That's right.
No blood?
It's a glorified body.
Glorified body, is that blood?
A glorified body does not apply. We have to live by the applied laws of dynamics, the applied laws of physics, but he doesn't.
All right.
Once you got the glorified body, you know, those laws do no longer count.
Okay. So a bloodless body, because the corruption of the body is in the blood?
Yeah. The life is in the blood, but also you get rid of the blood. It's just different. It's a glorified body.
The Antichrist ought to be able to look up a big giant used clothing store. Because everybody's going to leave. Your body's
going to
take on new form and new clothes.
Well, I had this idea.
Are we going to meet clothes on?
Yeah.
Well, the Bible says we're going to have robes.
Yeah.
Our robes are going to be white. What I was going to say is that it don't really matter, because we're, you know, it's going to be glorified bodies. But also, I thought about what if I was up there working on that two-story platform at Procter & Gamble, and I'm up there, and nobody wants to come up with me because it's so strenuous of a job under by myself, and all of a sudden the rapture takes place. And they come up and looking at my clothes and said, he's finally lost it. He's out here running around naked in the warehouse. Like, oh, I've been raptured away. I'm pretty sure.
They're probably sitting there saying, I hope this pilot ain't gone.
I'm gonna tell you, no, look, I can tell you, I'm gonna tell you that there's gonna be a Sunday. Listen, there's gonna be a Sunday when every church out here is gonna be packed to the brim. Mm-hmm. Packed to the brim. People are running to get in the doors. And that's gonna be the Sunday after the rapture. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's gonna be like how many folks were lined up trying to get in the park when the door shut?
Yeah, too late. Yeah. Right, too late. Yeah.
Thousands. That's the thing. What are people, you might have answered this out there, people that die after the rapture has taken place, what happened? Because they weren't saved when the rapture happened.
Okay, there's, again, this is groups of categories of people. There's going to be, according to, and of course, this some people are going to would take me down on the ground and wrestle me over this, but the Bible says, if you look at the Laodicean age, it says, you're cold and I'm going to spew you out of my mouth, which is believed by most scholars, and I believe it too, it means he's going to spew you into the tribulation period. Okay? So the Christians, the hot Christians, are going to go up in the rapture. The cold Christians are going to be right here. I hate to say this, but that's going to be the sun. If the rapture took place on Sunday morning, if some churches would not even know it.
Mm-hmm.
They wouldn't. They would have no idea. They get out and go, "What's all this about? We had a good service today. We were packed." And said, "Yeah, did you leave with the same people who came in?" "Yeah, okay." Okay, but
I went to a Baptist church not long ago, a couple Sundays ago, and there's a song that says, "I'm just following the motions, but you know, you're not feeling anything." That's what I felt like.
I had one guy tell me, one Baptist preacher told me his church was going first in the rapture. And I said, "Oh, come on now. You're that awesome of a preacher that your church is going first in the rapture. Your people are that awesome." He says, "No, the Bible study says we're going." I said, "How do you know your church is going first in the rapture?" He said, "Because the Bible says the dead in Christ shall rise first." But look.
The 10 virgins.
Yeah, there's 10 virgins, 5 foolish and 5 wise.
Yeah.
And that shows you about, that shows you 50%.
Yeah. Okay. Half of them go in the rapture.
That's right. So here you go. There's going to be those that go in the rapture, that go through the tribulation. Now, here's what it's going to be. That there's going to be the tribulation period. During that time, one of the ways you can go into rapture is to live for Christ. The way you go into tribulation is to die for Christ. Okay? So there's a big difference. Live for Christ now or die for Christ then. Now, if you die for Christ, then you're going to be taken before the Lord there, and you'll be redeemed. There's going to be people
that will be sin. Is that the judgment that will be sin that you come out after the tribulation?
You're going to have to face that judgment. Yes, you're going to have to die for Christ. But the ones that make it all the way through, that are saved, there's going to be children born in the tribulation period. There's going to be people born in the millennial reign. That's why, and people born in the millennial reign are going to live for 1,000 years. So, and the people that make it through the tribulation are going to be in that millennial, and they're going to be in that 1,000 years. So, that's why at the end of the 1,000 years, Satan's going to be released from the pit. And he's going to, after Jesus has ruled this earth for 1,000 years with a rod of iron, and there's been no sin. At the end of 1,000 years, he's going to release Satan from the pit. Satan then is going to deceive the nations, and there's going to be one more war. And this time, it's over. But the reason he's got to release Satan from that pit for 1,000 years is because those that are born in the tribulation period, or those born in tribulation and rapture, I mean tribulation and millennial period, have to have the same opportunity to be tempted and the same opportunity to accept Jesus over Satan. So that's what that's there for. Then after that, then it's gonna be fun time. I haven't seen it. I don't know how biblical that is. Left Behind by the new remakes all the time. But if this, I'll check it out. If not that big, Left Behind, we can have a Sunday night coming and watch Left Behind. Because it is, it's a visual. If you think about why, and you see that preacher, I know why the preacher didn't make it, because he was with Walker Texas Ranger. And yeah, but he laid there and said, "God, what did I do? How did I miss it?" He's laying in an empty church. "God, how did I miss it?" But God used him. And God used that pilot. You know, so yeah. All right, then we'll do that.
He didn't miss the second
one. That's right. All right, y'all. If there's any more questions, we actually have been here until it's 9 o'clock.
Yes.
And y'all have asked a bunch of questions.
Well, I think we need another discussion class like this.
We'll do it next week. We'll do it next week.
Okay.
And y'all, all week, I got a question.
And I'll tell you what you do. Do me a favor. is if you think of a question before Tuesday, how about shoot me a text so I can be prepared?
Hey, you do good on the spot.
I appreciate that, but.
You don't want other stuff like that. You're going to make it
smart. Do what now?
Oh, you got
at the mass they do that, and they gave us like 30 questions at the last walk, and they gave us we got about 10 or 12 of them